Hello everybody, in this video I'll be showing you guys how to copy a component from one game object onto another game object. So the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a new folder, and I'm going to call this scripts. And then I'm going to create a new C# script inside of it, and I'm going to call this extension methods. I'm going to open it up in Visual Studios here, and I'm not going to need this mono behavior here, and I'm going to make this class a static class. Now, for those that don't know what extension methods is, I have a link in the description for a video made by Unity on how to use extension methods. I recommend you guys go watch that before you guys continue on with this tutorial. Okay, so once you guys have gone and watched that, you guys are going to want to make a public static. And for now, it's going to return void. And I'm going to call it copy component. And then I'm going to need T for the component. I'm actually going to call this T component. And I'm actually going to also make this return T component instead of void. Now, I'm going to write this game object, and it's going to be called destination. Then I'm going to write T component. I'm going to call this original component. And now I'm going to write where T is component. T component is component. So we make sure this T grid op, this generic is of type component here. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the type of the component. So to that, I'm going to write type, which is in the using system namespace. And I'm going to name this component type. And it's going to equal original component dot get type. Now I'm going to write component. Component. And we can call this copy, and it's going to equal destination dot add component, and it's going to be of type component type. Now what we're going to need to do is we're going to need to write field info. Actually, first of all, I should probably explain to you what the code is doing so far. So first, we're getting the type of the component that we are trying to copy. And we're going to add the component right here. Now we're going to get all the fields of the original component and put those values into this new component. So that's why we need to write field info, which is inside the system.reflection namespace. And we're going to need an array of field infos. So now I'm going to call this fields. And it's going to equal component type dot get fields. So now we have all the different fields on our component. Now, currently, this doesn't actually have any value besides the default value for the fields. What we're going to do is we're going to go write field, because we just are doing a for. First of all, we're doing a for each loop to cycle through all of our fields. So field dot set value. So I'm going to set this field value onto my copy component, and it's going to be the same value as the field dot get value from the original component. Now we're just going to have to return the copy, and that's how you guys copy a component. Now I'm going to go ahead and just show off how to use it here. So if you guys don't want to look at that, you guys can just click off the video right now. But first of all, I realized the copy right here is going to error because I need to write it as T component. Okay, there we go. We now have no errors. Now I'm going to create a new script. I'm going to call this copy. I'm going to open it up in Visual Studios and get rid of the start and update functions. I'm going to make a public. And this needs to be public for two reasons. One, because that will allow us to access it in this fields thing right here. And two, because we need to see it in the inspector. So public string, and I'm going to call this underscore string. Now I'm going to go close out of Visual Studios and make a new script. And I'm going to call this test. I'm going to go ahead and open up in Visual Studios also. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the default start and update functions and make my own start function. Okay, now in my start function here, I'm going to write game object, and I'm going to call this new game object actually. And it's going to equal a new game object, and I'm going to name it game object, and I'm going to write new game object dot copy component, and I'm just going to write open parenthesis. Now I've got to pass in the original component. I'm going to pass in get component of type copy though. Now what this should do is it should copy my copy component onto this new game object that I'm creating. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new game object. I'm going to call it test right here. And try and drop my test script onto it. And now I need to drag and drop my copy script on it. I'm going to change this string right here to the Ash bot. And now I'm going to save my scene and then press play. Now I should see the Ash bot right here is on my new script. Now if I want to, I can change this to be Bob. I can press play one more time and we will see it's going to be Bob on this one. So there you guys have it. If you guys have any questions, just leave it in the comments. Please give this video a like.